Hey. What's up, folks? It's Friday. Well, guess you figured that one out. Saturday morning in Australia, in Japan, and other places over there. Yeah, what's up, people? Okay, it's Friday night. I know it's the middle of August now. A lot of people are now going out to things. So I don't know how many people are going to be watching, but it looks like a lot already. So thanks. If you got some friends that you know at are home, you can share this link to them as well. I'm just saying. All right, what's going on? How's everybody doing? Are you feeling all right? I do have to give a shout out to Cecil Ramirez. Going through some stuff right now, but you know what? It's going to be all right. It's going to be all right. What up, Cecil? All right, sending some love out to Sacramento. Okay, who all is here tonight? Liz West is staying cool in San Antonio. I don't believe that. LaRonda. She's like, I'm not going anywhere. It is hang night. Well, all right, stay.
Stay with
yes.
It.
LaRonda is staying with it. Linda Boney made it in. She made it. Hi. Come to Atlanta, bro. Come to Atlanta. Joe, I am going to be there November 11th. Yes. Lots of tour dates are on my webpage, brianculberson.com. Marcus Anderson joining the tour. Yeah. An evening with. That's what we're calling it. An evening with Brian Culberson. Hello. A lot of great musicians. Marquell Jordan is joining us. Chris, Eddie, Showcase, Rashawn, Patches. It's going to be a great show. And they're all going to be in Chicago, too, at the Chicago Jazz Getaway. And you know the Hang Club members. We're doing a special meet and greet in Chicago. So there you go. If you're not in the Hang Club, you know. Get with it. You can't say stay with it. All right, Sheila is listening in your car. Oh, all right. Hope you're not watching. You're listening. It's like a podcast. Hey, Nancy.
Stay with it.
Nancy Moore, hello. Las Vegas is here. However, you are going to a show tonight. All right, well, see, I told you, people are starting to go out. But, you know, if you're not out, maybe you can still watch. I was joking the other night. You can be at a show right now. With your phone down in your purse or wherever it is, and had one earpiece, you know, like the dude at like the one random dude at church is watching football with the earpiece. No, I'm just playing. You could be that person. You could be somewhere still watching the Hang. All right. What's going on? Who else is here? Decatur, Georgia. Hello, Barbara. Baltimore, Maryland is in the house. Hello, Francine. What's going on? All right. Gwen is staying home. She's like, no, I'm staying home. Margaret Holloman is here. Hello. She's like, I'm here. Newburgh, New York. Hello.
Stay with it.
Yes. Pamela is ready to come to Chicago and see us at the Getaway. Yes. DC in the house.
Stay.
What up? Asheville, North Carolina. Yes, I know. I know Marcus Anderson, his jazz and coffee escape is going on right now. Friday night. So some people are there. I know Jezalyn is there. A lot of people are there. But I bet you she's one of those people watching in the audience. She's got one eye and an ear on Marcus on stage. And an earpiece and another eye on her phone watching the Hang in the purse. I'm just playing. Maybe she's not. I don't know these things. Whatever it is, hope you're staying with it.
Stay.
Yes, Cincinnati, Ohio is here. Hello, Donita. How you doing? Winter Haven, Florida. I don't know where that is. Hello, Misty. Yeah. Calumet City is in the house right down the street. Yes. Odessa, Florida. Okay. Terrence, I am at the house before the hang. I love that. Flagstaff, Arizona. Ooh, that's beautiful there. LaGrange, Georgia is in the house. Hello, hello. Oh, this is the pre-show. Tonight we're talking about mastering. What is mastering? I don't know. Do you know? Do you think you know? People think they know. Some people think it's like, man, that's some marketing. That's some marketing BS. I don't believe it. I don't trust it. Well, you know what? Tonight, I'm going to explain it all. Well, at least give you an overview. That's what we're doing. And I'm going to play some songs. Michael Linkton is stopping by. Both Michael Linktons. Michael Linkton and Michael Linkton are stopping by the hang. You'll see. All right, let me get this together. I'm going to go. This show is going to start in 1 minute. I'm slightly late tonight. My bad. It's summertime. What are you going to do? All right, Audrey. Montgomery, Alabama is here. You got your tickets to Birmingham. Birmingham. I'm ready. All right, here we go. Here we go. Ready? 3, 2, 1. And we're about to start. What? Okay.
Bam.
Hey, it's Brian Culbertson. We're live. And it's Friday night.
Whoa.
Yes, it is. And I'm telling you right now, I got... It's unbelievable. I fixed this camera 3 times tonight, and it's still not staying with it. What? It's Friday night. I don't know what's going on. There we go. I think there's a bug in the system. What? All right, let's go over here. I don't know what the hell is going on. But you know what? We're not going to worry about it. This is live television, folks. And 3 weeks in a row, that camera needs to stay with it. What?
It's Friday night.
Oh, it's Friday night. It's Friday. We're talking about mastering.
It's Friday night.
It's Friday night. Yeah. It's Friday night. It is. What? Yeah. All right, you've made it. You're here. We are here together. We're hanging out. What are we doing? I'm talking about mastering, folks. You know, the final thing before you get it. You know, the whole album making process is a long process, as you know. You know, you got to write the songs. There's pre-production. There's production. Recording. Everybody comes in. You're doing this and that. There's editing. There's all this kind of stuff. And then there's mixing. We know what that entails. After it's all mixed, you send the final mixes to the mastering engineer. Yes. Let me get a sip. What am I drinking? Lil B, what am I drinking? We're drinking Round Pond. It's summertime, so I am fully in the Sauvignon Blanc, you know, situation there. Okay. It's very good. Crisp. Crisp and clean. Let me get a sip. You good? You got something in the glass? I hope you do. Somebody's like, yeah, I got margaritas. I'm like, hello, excuse me. All right, I'm feeling good. So yes, mastering is the final process, and we're gonna talk about it all night tonight. But I'm gonna play some songs too, because you know, I'm not gonna get too in the weeds, as they say. I don't want to lose you. So we're gonna play some music. We're gonna talk about mastering. I'm gonna play some more music. Michael Linkton's dropping by. It's gonna be a fun night. So thanks for hanging out with us. Uh-huh. Yeah, me and me. It's me and me, and then never mind. What are we going to do first? I got a song for you. I'm going to start with this song because, it kind of fits the mood of, you know, where we're going with this mastering project. I'm doing songs from my catalog. That have kind of a oh yeah to it, if you know what I'm saying. Oh yeah. How you doing? Yes, we're doing songs tonight that kind of have a oh yeah to it. Because I'm mastering my new record, which is oh wait, hold on. Oh, it's over there. I'll show you in a minute. I got to test printing of the cover. Okay. That's another part of the process. That's a whole other thing. Artwork. We'll talk about that later. Not tonight. So the new album is called The Trilogy Part 1, colon, Red. Like, not written out colon. You know what I'm saying? The Trilogy, comma, Part 1, colon, you know, dot, dot, Red. All right. I've showed it to you before. You know what the cover looks like. I'll show it to you later, though. All right. So here's the deal. Let me go over to the Pro Tools rig because I have this set up. All right. Ready? Oh, there it is. Yes. Okay. So what I've done, yep, I'm going to move over here. Mind the wine. Yes. All right. We're over here. We're over at the Pro Tools rig. Oh, wait. I don't think I got that camera in the right position. Oh, well. Okay. You're going to see my shoulder. Stay with it. Okay. I'll have to move it later. So what I got here is I'm going to give you... Okay. Hi. That's the problem since I'm by myself. Okay. Let's check this out. I'm going to play you three things. The first one is my rough mix that I made myself. I mixed it myself just to kind of get an idea of what the song was sounding like. And you know, I'll just play this this song here. Feel the Love, track one. You know this song. Oh, Feel the Love. Oh, I gotta turn it down, it's too loud. Listening real quick. So, you know, it sounds nice, right? Okay, it's fine. Rough mix. Feel the Love, rough mix from Red. Test printing. All right, I'm gonna stop it now. Okay, so now I'm gonna play you the final mix. Remember we talked about mixing last month? So this is the difference between my rough mix, which I did, you know, quickly just to get an idea of what the song sounds like. And this now is the final mix. Me and Bob working back and forth a lot. Here's this final mix. Same song, same place. A lot cleaner, a lot tighter, a lot clearer. Everything's in its place nicely. You can hear everything clearly. Up nice. Feel the Love, final mix. All right, you get the idea though. All right, ready for this? Now I'm gonna play the mastered version, the final masters. Woo! Same place. Same song, final masters. right? Clearly a big difference. You know, let's go back now and listen to the rough mix. It's just like night and day. It's like a big blanket just got thrown on top of the speaker. Right? Isn't that crazy? I'll go back and forth. Rough mix, master. Rough mix, master. I'll do it through the chorus. Rough mix. Rough mix. Master. All right. You're at home like, holy cow. I didn't know. All right. So to answer any of your, you know, apprehension about what does mastering do? Now it's clear. It's clear cut. What does it do? I'll tell you what it does exactly. All right, I'm going to pull this over. Remember this? I had this for mixing. Okay, here's our glossary of terms for mastering. So in a way, there's similarities to mastering to mixing. Because the first thing you want to do is get the volume of each song the same, consistent. So in mixing, you're trying to get the volumes of all the individual instruments at their correct volume and make sure you can hear everything correctly. But once all that's mixed in one file, then the mastering engineer takes each song, because each song gets delivered as its own song. It's just one file, one piece of digital information, right? Used to be on tape, analog. Now it's 99.9% digital. Okay, so first thing you want to do is get the volume of each song consistent so that when you, as a consumer, are listening to an album, you don't have to constantly reach for your volume knob or your volume button. You want song to song to song to song to sound the same apparent volume. It's not as easy as you think. You can't just look at the meters. Oh, it looks the same. No. You have to listen to it and really use your ears, because apparent volume is different than volume on the meters. Apparent volume is how does it feel? How does it sound to you in your ears? So there's a lot of back and forth between the mastering engineer and myself as the producer, making sure that every song is leveled out properly. Even yesterday, I was changing the levels of one song. Okay, track one, bring down a half a dB. They're really, really subtleties. But I think it makes a big difference so that you, as a listener, don't have any issues. It all just sounds fine and lovely, you know? I don't want complaints from you. So that's number one. All right, we'll check that off. That's pretty obvious, right? Number two. Remember EQ? EQing. Equalization. You know, in rough terms, the bass, mids, and treble. In mastering, they get really, 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 really nitty-gritty. Like we're talking a quarter of a dB down on a tiny little frequency. And these are things that I don't necessarily even hear. I'm telling you. It takes a real, really good mastering engineer to know these subtleties. And ultimately, what they're trying to do is make each song consistent, not just volume-wise, but EQ-wise. For instance, you don't want one song sounding like it has bass that's going to rattle the neighborhood, but then the next song, not enough bass. So a mastering engineer can even those kinds of things out so that the album, in essence, sounds consistent from start to finish, from song to song to song. Even if you go from song one to eight, it should sound consistent. It should sound the same. And that's what a mastering engineer does. When you're mixing, it's virtually impossible to make that happen because you're super hyper-focused. Yes, that's a word. You're super hyper-focused on making sure... Sorry, I know I was cut off there. Hello. You're so hyper-focused on, you know, the individual instrument tracks that you can't really be bothered to make the song to song to song to song consistent. Not to that degree. So the mastering engineer does that. So that's two. All right? Number three. And this also has to do with levels, but it's a different kind of level. The mastering engineer gets an album, your album, into what's called commercial level. So if you listen to, let's listen again, to the level of the final mix. Now let's listen to the mastering. This is the final mix. Mastering. Here is much louder mix. Master. And the reason why we have to do that is so commercial level basically is it's similar to all the other releases that are out there. So this is kind of a third level check. What you don't want is you're listening to, you know, pick another artist, and then you go to my record, and it's either too loud or too soft. Well, that's not good either. I mean, sometimes that still happens, but ultimately, you want to get your album in the ballpark with everyone else's albums. So, you know, it's not too loud or too soft. Yes. So there's that. So commercial level. It's also called limiting with no, you don't want overs. Overs are when you see the red light. That means there could be distortion. Very bad. I hate distortion. No one likes distortion unless it's on a guitar and it's supposed to be there. You know what I'm saying? But distortion because something is poorly done, that's not good. That's digital distortion. No bueno. Very bad. We don't want that. I need a drink. Are you with me so far? Are you staying with me? I hope so. I hope it's not too crazy. Okay. So that's the first three things with mastering. So you're getting a grasp of it. Should I go play another song? Yes, I should. Will you follow me over there? I hope you will. Ah, yes. What am I doing next? Oh, yeah. Uh-huh.
This song is for you, baby.
Yeah. Little skies wide open with Avant.
Sing their song, and the wind hums along.
Oh yeah. Songs that make you go, oh yeah, tonight. Because we're mastering Trilogy Part 1. Well, it's technically done. Can you believe that? I was doing it all this week. I was working on it all this week. And here's the other thing you got to do with mastering. So one of the things that there's just no substitute for this. As the producer, as the artist, you have to listen to the album in its entirety from start to finish over and over and over, no matter how tired you may get of doing it. Here's the reason. This is part of the mastering process, at least for me. I start hearing more and more things and more subtle things the more I listen to it, and making sure that there are no little tiny distortions created. There are no, like one song slightly too loud next to the other one. Basically, you know, I don't want to be annoyed. That's what it comes down to it. Mixing and mastering are getting the song and the production into a place to where I, as the artist and producer, are no longer annoyed at anything that you're hearing. Does that make, that pretty much sums it all up. So currently, I'm not annoyed at anything on this whole new record, which means it's done. That's what it means. Should we go back over here? I think we should. All right. It is subtle. Yeah. All right. We're going back over. Follow me over there. What's next? What's next on the list? All right. Okay. Ah, yes. The song order. Ever wonder how the songs on a CD, you know, get put on 1, 2, 3, 4, you know, through whatever? Well, the mastering engineer does that. He takes your mixes and puts them in order in his computer program, and then adds the ID at a specific place. I always choose exactly where the ID goes. So if you put it in your CD player and you hit forward, it goes to the start of the next song. Sometimes there's a slight gray area because if a song, you know, fades into the next song. So I, as the producer, have to choose where does that digital ID go so that when you hit forward or skip to the next song, it goes to, you know, where I want it to go. Make sense? Okay. So the song order and the digital IDs, the IDs, that's a mastering engineer's job. The song order is also called the sequencing of songs. That is decided by the producer, artist. So I'm telling the mastering engineer what the order is. And then he puts them in order. Okay. What else does he do? The spacing between each song. Yes. Have you ever felt that from song to song on a particular record, you're like, dang, there's a lot of space. This is annoying. Why is there so much space in between the last song and then the next one? No. Well, the mastering engineer did that. But ultimately, that, again, is up to the producer or artist or artist producer what they want. Sometimes they actually want space in between songs. And I understand sometimes they want space so that you can kind of bask in the afterglow of each song separately. Does that make sense? For instance, you're finishing a song and there's 4 seconds of silence before the next song starts. Well, you do have time to think about something, and hopefully you're thinking about and reflecting on the song that you just heard and not, you know, what you're going to make for dinner. Okay. So song spacing. That is done in mastering. All right. So let me give you an example. All right. So let me go back to Pro Tools here. Okay. Let me just go up to a song that kind of overlaps a little bit. Okay. So the end of Infatuation. you hear that transition? All right, so that's an overlap, meaning the end of infatuation melds into the beginning of track 5, which is Deep in the Night, the cricket noise. So let's listen again to the very end, to this part right here. That's the transition part. Right? Okay, so without mastering, you just have the songs separated. For instance, actually, let me do this. So if I go to the final mixes and play the same thing, here's what happens. First of all, it'd be softer, so. Listen. See, way too much time in there. We don't need all that. So the mastering can take both files and kind of overlap the tails, if you will. So that is done in mastering. Now you know. All right. So every song, you know, you got to decide that. What is the spacing between each song? Very important. All right. So now we got that. Boom. Let me go play another song. Yes, another oh yeah song.
Yeah, I think so.
All right.
What do I got?
Oh. If nothing lasts forever. All right, Kathy wanted to hear this one. Yeah. Would be so afraid. Mm-hmm. It's kind of a. This is a mix. It could be an oh yeah, but it. Never mind. Natalie Stewart, a.k.a. the Flowicist. That's her on the vocals. She wrote the poetry there. Song from my 12 CD called I Don't Know. I don't know. But what I do know is it's time to give some birthday shout-outs. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. All right. Who's celebrating birthdays this week? What do we got? Hang Club members. Here's who's celebrating. Errol Clark. Hey, Errol. Pam Barrett. Annette Buell. Liz Isant. How's that painting doing? Who else? Oh, Wanda Hall. Hey. Sharon DeShillitz. Whoops.
Hold on. I need louder music.
Sharon Shillitz. DeShillitz. I gotta work on this. Maya Hamblett. All right. Donald Allen. What up, Donald? Dwight Moss. Omar Sprob. Tracy D. Minor. Ooh, D. Minor. The saddest of all keys. Did you know that? All right, hey, we got anniversaries. Bobby and Rick Hayward, 27 years. Lori and Ron Trout, 38 years. And Willie and Deborah Raspberry, 44 years. Congrats, you guys. Yeah. Oh, okay. There we go. Happy birthday to you if you're celebrating. I saw some people in the post earlier. They were like, hey, wish me a happy birthday. So happy birthday to everyone celebrating. Mm-hmm. All right, what else we got going on? You know what? I think it's time. I think it's time to get this going right now. Are you ready? My friend Michael Linkton is dropping by. But he's not just dropping by once. He's dropping by twice. And I'll tell you about it afterwards. Yeah. Say what?
We'll be right back.
Michael Linkton. And Michael Linkton in the house. And congratulations to Michael, who just got married on Sunday. So, yeah. Yeah, there you go. Okay, yeah, yeah. Congrats, Michael. Yeah, that's so cool. Great wedding photos, if you haven't seen them. Well, he sent me one. Okay. Anyway, there it was. Say what? That was from his Stage It show a couple weeks ago. And by the way, this Sunday, in 2 days from now, Michael's doing another Stage It show, and he's doing all songs by Stevie Wonder. So check this out. Michael Linkton, the music of Stevie Wonder, this Sunday, August 8th at 5 p.m. Pacific time. I'm assuming just go to Michael's website for a link there. It's on Stage It. So there you go. Now you know. Yeah. Oh, special guest, Ellis Hall. That's going to be amazing. So we got to tune in for that. All right. Now you know. Michael Linkton. Thanks, man. Three Hats. The Three Hats Show. Oh, my goodness. Hey, I got a little bit more info to tell you about mastering. So let's go back over there. Yes.
I'm not done yet.
I am not done yet. We have a little bit more so that you know all the things. All the things. Hi. How's this drinking? It's pretty good. Yeah. Mm. Okay, so what's next on the list? Let's recap, first of all. We got the volume of each song, the equalization of each song, making sure it's at commercial level with no distortion. We put the songs in order. Duh. We make sure the space in between each song is correct. What else does the mastering engineer do? He adds the metadata that populates. Let's say you put your CD player in the car, if you still have one. Maybe you don't. Remember the, you know, my name and the album title and the song title show up. Well, the mastering engineer has to enter that info so that that happens. He also puts various other data so that it the song, if it gets played on the internet or the radio, gets tagged. So he puts that kind of metadata within the files. So, you know, that's boring stuff, but it has to be done, of course. Okay, adding metadata, other codes and various things. So the final thing the mastering engineer does is create the final master. It's called the final master. And there's different masters for depending on where it's going. So he makes a master specifically for if you're printing physical CDs. It's called a DDP master. You don't need to know that. I'm not going to give you a test. He makes digital masters for like iTunes and Amazon and Spotify and Tidal or wherever you're listening digitally. That's one file that gets uploaded everywhere. And then he can also create masters for printing vinyl. I'm not doing vinyl for this project, but I have done it in the past. So that's a different final master. So that's the last thing that the mastering engineer does. I take it back. The last thing the mastering engineer does is send me an invoice. Hello. But down. Ah. So anyway, tell me to stay. mastering is not cheap. I'll just say that. You know, they do get paid well, but as they should, because, you know, this is the final step. It's the final step. It can't get past the mastering engineer's ears before being good, right? Although we've all heard masters that sound horrible, so what are you going to do? Anyway, you find a person that you like the way they master, and you keep using them over and over and over. And that's what I've done with both Bob Horn on the mixing side and Gene Grimaldi on the mastering side. So I think if you find a good team, you got to stick with it. Stay with it. Hello. That just works in so many scenarios, doesn't it? So there it was. Now you know all about mastering. That's what it is. Volume, EQ, commercial level, song order, song spacing, metadata, creating the final files that then go out to you, the final listener. Hello. Lots of finals there. You, the listener. Stay with it for real. All right. Well, now you know. Any other questions? All right. I'm going back over here. Shall we? Uh-oh. Watch the wine. Moving the microphone back. I think I have one more song. Before I let you go. One more song. I appreciate you being here tonight. I know, you know, sometimes the tech stuff is like, huh? But you know what? As a listener, I think you should know these things because ultimately it's going to make you appreciate the music more, have an understanding for how much goes into making a record, and I think it will make you listen more intelligently and, you know, with bigger ears. Does that make sense? All right. We got time for one more song? I think we do. Yeah. I told you. It's an all yeah night. Noel Gordine, you're my music.
First thing in the morning, I love the way you shine when the sun is rising. And every day, all I wanna do is hear your voice. It's like you strike a chord in my heart, babe. And even when it stops, you still sustain. You're the best melody in my life. 'Cause every time I think never ever stop till you're satisfied. Just open up and sing it to me loud and clear. Oh, this is real, no need to pretend. And I hope this will never end. 'Cause you're the only melody in my
every time I
Hey, by the way, next week, whoever sends the most stars tonight, the top 10 star senders, you get to pick the songs for next week. It's Star's Choice. Now you know. All right? So get them in. You got three more minutes. Get them in right now. Oh, yeah. But guess what? Right now. Oh, yes. We got to sing it out. All right. You still have a chance. Send in your stars right now. Top 10 star senders. Pick the songs for next week. What?
It's Friday night.
Sorry, that was loud.
It's Friday.
Ain't nobody mastering this show.
It's Friday night. It's Friday night.
You can't master it live. We're live. Did you know that?
Oh.
All right, you guys. Like I said, next week, I'm just going to play 10 songs that the top 10 star senders are going to pick. So, who's it going to be? Who gets to pick the music? We're about to find out tomorrow.
It's Friday night.
I'll check in the morning. I'll let you know.
It's Friday night.
Yeah. All right. Hey, another shout out to Cecil Ramirez. Hope you're feeling better, man. We'll check in this weekend. But to all of you, enjoy your weekend. Glad you had a good time tonight. And we'll catch you all next week. Later. Mm-hmm. Oh, there. Where is it? There it is. Stay with it. All right, folks. Oh, yes. What's up? All right. Who's still here? All right.
Stay.
Yeah. Carolyn Richie Jameson says, very informative. Awesome. Hey, well, I'm glad you enjoyed it. Oh, Brenda Jackson.
Stay with it.
Lori Harms.
Stay with it.
LaRonda. Uh-oh, she's at it again.
Stay with it.
Yes. Hey, Glenn wanted to know, do you use compression also? Yes, but sparingly. It's part of that limiting. So you have to use a little compression on certain frequencies, too. It's called multi-band compression. Let's say just the low end is popping out, so you put a compressor on just certain frequencies that... Anyway, that gets pretty technical. I didn't want to go into that too much tonight. But yes, compression is used, but sparingly. You want to get most of your intense compression done on the mix side. All right, there you go. Now you know. All right. Uh-oh. LaRonda. Oh, Lori Harms. Oh, she's working it. Katrina Tank.
Stay.
Well, oh, yeah, yeah. All right. Terry Johnson loves hearing the behind-the-scenes work. I'm glad you like it.
Stay.
Kathy, yes. I played your song.
Stay with it.
Daphne Harris. Oh, she is here and... All right, she's doing some things.
Stay with it.
By the way, Daphne is going to hold a red release party for all her girlfriends, and she's inviting them over and giving everybody a set of headphones, and they're gonna sit around, eat chocolate and drink wine and listen to Red. I don't know what you're gonna eat. I don't know, I'm guessing.
Stay with.
Ken Pristy. Yes, we're all in the showbiz now. We all, you know things now. So you gotta watch The Hang to know things.
Stay with it.
Transitions, right? It's crazy. You never thought about that before, did you? These are the things you got to think about. Uh-oh, Cynthia Fullwood.
Stay with
it. Hello. All right. Cheryl K. Jordan. Yeah. Yes, you got mastering education and music.
Stay with it.
LaRonda.
Stay with it.
Lady Coco. Your husband... Oh, is your sound engineer? Nice. Sylvia Lee, you are definitely invited over to Daphne's house. I think she's in New York, though. Are you in New York? I forget.
Stay with.
I can't remember all these things. Is Jeslyn still watching The Hang in the on the phone, in the purse, at Marcus Anderson's Jazz Escape right now? Is she... I'm just messing with you guys. Oh, yeah.
Stay
all right.
With.
DeAndra Allen.
Stay with.
Yes, I'm glad you enjoyed. Sarah Hager, I'm glad you, enjoyed. Ah!
Stay with it.
That's it for our time. We'll see who the top 10 star senders are. I'll let you know. They're picking the songs for next week.